Welcome to another episode of ASMR Reality. Tonight, we are going to check out a hoarder's house. This house is not a home I have for sale yet. This is probably a couple months away from being able to be sold because the family is still in the process of clearing out all this stuff. See, about half of the stuff has been removed already. There's an old barn on the property. We're going to go through that as well. So I hope you enjoy this one. It'll be a little bit different than some of the other ones we've checked out. This house, if it was done, it's on about 4 acres of property. It's in a city called Cicero, Indiana. Cicero, Indiana. If it was completed, if this house was completely redone, fully renovated, it's probably worth close to $1 million. The family thinks they can get about $600,000 to $700,000 as it sits. $600,000 to $700,000 as it sits. I don't think so. I think it's probably more like $400,000 as it sits. So I doubt that I'm going to end up with listing, but I'm at least trying. I did what's called a listing presentation. I went and checked out the home, and I talked to the family, but with this video, I'm going to put together some clips. I'm going to make a video with me talking to them in the video, throw a couple video clips in there of like some of the black mold that's in the house, and then I'm going to show some comps, some other homes in the area that were really nice that sold for less than $1 million, and then to give them some cost estimates on what this thing would cost to totally renovate, and it's a lot. This thing needs everything, so rather than just keep on telling you about it, how about we take a look at it? This is the front of the home, the front door. You can see there is no real sidewalk to the front door. The house is about 6,600 square feet. It is huge. Here is like a landscape bed that's not completed. The old man that lived here was very, very eccentric, and I think what happened, I think he had a lot of money, and instead of completing one project, he would just go on to another project. You can see some old like gates, and it does have a whole house generator. It has 2 air conditioners. There's a new propane tank and an old propane tank still on the property. For some reason, over here in this far corner, there's a buried toilet. That white porcelain in the corner, there is an upside down toilet, and I have no idea what it is. You can see like critter holes here, like raccoons or something have been digging holes there. There's really no landscaping to speak of. All of this back exterior is all vinyl siding, and it just needs removed. The concrete board needs to be put up. Also, you can look across the way there. The neighbor is very close. This property just doesn't have a lot of privacy. Most people that want acreage like the acreage to have a little bit of privacy, to be a little bit off the beaten path without, you know, being on top of a neighbor, but this has a neighbor pretty close by. That's the reason I would not want it. I like to have a little bit of separation. You can see the trees right now. This is fall in Indiana, and the trees are starting to turn, and it's very pretty here. This barn is old, early 1900s barn, and I'll go through it here in just a moment. I just wanted to do a quick kind of exterior walk around. The overall land needs to be regraded. The driveway is just rocks. They're just horrible. It does have a 4-car garage. You could see some of the boxes sitting outside. They had, while I was here, some of the items that were in the home. I think this is where I probably should have cut this part out, because there's a good view of the front of the home. There's my fence, of course. Yeah, there's a couple of the other trees that just, you can see the leaves changing. And then, okay, so now we're actually walking back to the back of the barn. I'm going to walk you through the barn first, and then we're going to go through the house. I don't know why, but I actually like old barns. I don't know what it is, but they really, they inspire me for some reason. Maybe I've, in another life, maybe I was a farmer or something. This back part of the barn is in pretty bad shape, but the main structure of the barn is pretty good. There's several stalls for livestock. You could probably house about 20 to 25 animals in this barn. You can see the roof there is like caving in. This back part is caving in, but it's all fixable. It's definitely nothing that I would tear down. I think it would be easy to fix this. But there's no concrete foundation. You know, it's just a dirt floor. It is truly an animal barn, but even in here, he has stuff. This is the part that really kind of confuses me about humans. It's like, why do we collect stuff that we don't use? I just really don't understand why humans are so into stuff. You know, I like, you. If you guys haven't seen my home tour video, you can go through my house. I mean, I don't have very much stuff. Because I like to be clean, and I just don't like to have stuff I don't use. It just gets in the way. I think homes look better if you don't have a lot of stuff, but just like a few items that look good. So this is the four-car garage. The way he had it, he could not pull a single car into here because he had nothing but stuff out here. And again, you're seeing this where we can actually walk through it, because before it was so full you couldn't even get through. The first time I wasn't even able to make a video because I couldn't even walk through the house. There were parts of the house you could not get to. Those are the front doors, so I just walked up front so we can kind of pretend like we walked in the front door. You can see a stairway going up. Off to the side here, you have your first bedroom. This is like a guest room, and if you look in there, there's no lights on in that bathroom, but that's actually a bathroom with a shower, but there's no sink, no vanity, nothing. This is a recent addition he added on. It's a three-story library, and you can see the drywall is unfinished. It was just full of garbage. There's no flooring in there. Then we move into the main original living area. Then into like a formal dining area. Now these actually look decent right now because all the clutter has been removed. Then we actually step up into a raised kitchen. And again, all the counter stuff has been removed. They're in the process of boxing it all up. Then this is like a second eating area. Then we walk back here into this hallway. You've got a laundry room. Then you've got this is the initial primary bedroom or master bedroom. And then it has a, like its own little office area in the master bedroom. This would be the closet area of the master bedroom. And then the actual master bath. And all of it just needs redone. It's in horrible condition. There's black mold everywhere. I think as we walk through this extra room, this is going to go through a second bedroom now. This is a hall bath, which is actually connected to, it's connected to this second bedroom. So that other door, that door right there in the distance, that door actually you can access. access from this bedroom. So this bedroom was like a, like I think it was a teenager's bedroom. You could see the Hollywood sign, and then there's this band poster. I've never heard of them, called Under Oath. Maybe one of you guys have heard of them, Under Oath. I've never heard of them. I meant to look up some of their music when I got home, but I forgot. Okay, so that's one wing of the home. So that's another issue with the house, is it has got a very weird layout. It's just like it's been added on to and added on to and added on to, but none of it was ever finished. Now, initially, I thought this was a basement. Well, it's not. It's a crawl space. It's not a true basement because it's only like a 6 foot ceiling. So I'm 5'9", and I could barely, like, there were parts of this I had to duck down, but this is just like a mechanical area. So even though this is not like an official true basement, you can, I was checking out like the electrical boxes, but you can see all the garbage he has stored down here. You know, I'm like, if you just, it's like people that get storage facilities. It's like if you really just got so much stuff that you have to put it in storage, well, you obviously don't need it. So it just doesn't make any sense. But I know hoarding is a true disease, and I'm not trying to be mean to those people, but it's sad. We're walking up the stairs, and there's actually plastic on these stairs, which is kind of weird. I guess they're just trying to protect the carpet, because everything, this house has always been under construction and never been done. This is just like a big foyer, like another like living area upstairs. It's just kind of weird that it's there. Then we walk to the left here, and we there's those stairs right there go to a, on the side, go to a new master bedroom. This is another bedroom here, which again was just used for storage. And I think this is a closet. Yeah, a closet with a bunch of chests in there. And then this is like a mechanical room. So this would be like the upstairs furnace, which that thing is opened up like they're working on it. And then we walk into this new master bedroom. Again, no flooring in this because it's never been completed. But it was used for storage. And again, this has gotten hardly nothing in it compared to before. This is the master bath. You can see all the junk in here that was never completed. This master bath was, and there's the master closet. It was actually using it as a closet. But there's the tub just sitting there. It's never been connected. Just most, if somebody said you could have everything in this house, I would not take it for free. It's just too much garbage. It's just, there might be something in there of value, but you have to sort through all the trash to find it. No thanks. Now, as we walk over, we're back into that upstairs living area. And now we're walking over to this new addition that he added on this library. So we look down, and there is the library, the main floor of the library. This is like the second floor of the library. And looking up, you can see like the skylights and then the side lights as well. It's really pretty, like it could be like a magnificent home. But you see the wood, the floors here are just plywood. There's no flooring. There's no trim on the baseboard. You can look up. I don't know if you can get a good look at that, but I was trying to show you where the drywall is separated. So like all the drywall needs to be redone in this whole house. And then we walk into this, I don't even know what you call this other room. Now I gotta get a good view of the, I was pointing at something, yeah. There's the splits, so you can see the ceiling is split there. It all needs redone. Like, this is because he didn't have it heated and cooled, so it got hot in there, then it got cold in there, and it just, he doesn't have electricity in some parts of the house, so the guy was just so eccentric. That's one of the family members walking through there. And I still gotta walk you through one massive part of this house. There we go. So this is like above the garage. So this room is gigantic. There's a bathroom that again has not really been completed. it. There's a sink in there, but nothing else. And then this was a room that he kept a lot of artwork in, so there's probably some valuable stuff in here. But looking around, I think most of the art was just, I mean, I don't think these skylights are covered with canvas, so who knows what's underneath there. I think maybe he did that so that it would not fade out the photos, the pictures that he had in there. But again, look at all this stuff. There's more of that drywall cracked. Like, all of that needs to be redone. And now, as I go back out here, I try to look at some of this artwork for you so that you can see. There might be some cool pieces in here, but most of this stuff, I think that, like, some of it was, like, poster art. And I'm like, I know those things aren't worth that much money. Like, this is some sort of Jamaican, you know, advertisement. So I just don't, again, lots of pictures and frames, and he was going to hang all this stuff up, but he collected it but never used it. It just sat on the floor, you know. I'm like, that's why it is truly a disease. He never really got to enjoy it. Now, maybe he came into this room and just glanced through them. I asked the family member, why is this door locked? And she said that's where he kept the art he considered expensive. So I didn't get to see that. So in his defense, maybe he does have some expensive pieces in there. But yeah, this is, I feel sorry for the family, because now this is what happens when you die and you leave a mess like this to your family. Now, I'm sure they get some money for it, but it just, I tell you what, it just doesn't. It just motivated me to continue to stay clean and to not allow myself to ever get to this place. This is why I think it's important to have animals, because animals can keep you from, they require so much of your time. They can keep you from having to get all this stupid stuff. Yeah. What do you think? Speaking of animals, Pearl was not there before. Look who showed up. I had to wait to record tonight because she's been like, she was under my desk and her tail was hitting the desk. And so, like, I started the video and then pop, 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 pop. I had to stop. But I love her. And, you know, she keeps me from being a hoarder. So I appreciate that. This video might be a little bit shorter than normal because I didn't have a lot of video footage of the house. I kind of felt uncomfortable filming with the family there, but I told them I was just doing it to try to get some estimates. I didn't have the heart. Probably had a guilty conscience because I knew I was going to make an ASMR video with it. But one day I might get busted doing this, but so far nobody's caught me doing it. It's like my own little covert project to share these videos with you guys so that you can see some of the things that I go through in my career. But I do feel like, you know, there's a saying that says cleanliness is next to godliness. I don't know who created that saying, and I really don't know the premise other than to say that being clean is associated with being good. But I really feel like when you live in an organized environment, your life feels better to wake up and you're in a clean house. Just feels good. I think if you wake up into chaos and clutter, it's like all you do is, like, you look around and you see all these projects that need to be done, and I don't think it's healthy. I don't think it could be healthy. Like, I'm doing a construction project at my house right now where I'm creating a third car garage, so a place that I can park my Land Cruiser so that I can park my NSX and my Venza in the garage, because to show you this video. It's going to be maybe my best video yet, but the point is that living through that dust and work, even in that, even doing that, I try to make sure that even though it's under construction, that at the end of the day, it's clean. It's in a organized fashion, so that the next morning when the workers get there, they can be more efficient. I think the workers appreciate a cleaner job site. So I know that trying to have your life be in better harmony, I know that if you keep your life better organized, maybe you still live with your parents, then you should keep your room clean. Your room should be the cleanest room in the house, because all you have is a room, right? It's like you don't have a whole house to clean yet. So if you just have a room to take care of, you should make sure that it is spotless and organized and inviting. And then if maybe one of your friends comes over unexpectedly, if they came into your room, it would be something you would be proud of and proud to present. And it's the same way with my house. I never know if somebody's going to stop by here. And I just like to be ready, you know. It matters, and it just makes me feel better. Like these dogs, my dogs shed like crazy. So not only did I do a house tour video, I made a video of me cleaning my house. And the thumbnail, if you wanted to look it up, just has me. I think I'm wiping down the refrigerator in the thumbnail. But and it says something about cleaning, house cleaning on the thumbnail. But the point is every day I shop vac my floors so that there's to clean the dog hair up, because if I didn't, there would be tumbleweeds of hair throughout my house. But it's the price I pay to have dogs to shed, but they're worth it, and it's easy to do. It takes me probably 20 minutes a day. It's easy to find the 20 minutes to do the shop vac, and I just think it's necessary. It's necessary for me to feel productive. I work better. I feel better in a clean environment, and I believe everybody does, and I believe everybody has it in them to do it. I just think that people, you know, like on a house like that, the guy probably woke up and just thought, where do I even start? Because it's just overwhelming. And I liken it to like losing weight. If somebody's 100 pounds overweight, they wake up, they feel like, they feel bad. And they think, I gotta lose 100 pounds. I just don't have the energy to even try today. Instead, what they should do is say, I need to lose 100 pounds, but I'm going to focus on 5 pounds at a time. I'm going to lose 5 pounds. And if you start with something small, then you start weighing yourself, then you lose that 5 pounds, and you feel the victory. You feel the satisfaction. You feel the joy of accomplishing something. And it motivates you to move on to the next 5 pounds. And it's the same thing with a house like that. Or maybe it's the same thing with your room. Maybe it's just a mess, a colossal mess, and you're just like, I don't even know where to start. Well, how about you start with just your bed? Take anything that's on there that shouldn't be on there, take it off. Make the bed. You know, start there. Now you've got a made bed. Okay, so the bed looks good in the room. my short sleeve dress shirts in another section, my vests, my jackets, my athletic shirts that are all hanging up. They're all in a section. They're all where they should be. And then like t-shirts like this, I just have folded in a drawer. You know, socks and underwear, that type of stuff. If you have a dedicated spot for everything, and it's part of being organized. And I believe that keeping your environment organized will help you keep your mind organized, because if you live in an organized environment, it's like a positive disease. It spreads to your body. Maybe you can organize your body better now. Maybe you can organize your thoughts better now because your room's cleaner. Maybe your mind will be cleaner, you know. Or maybe you start with your mind. Maybe you start with your body. Start working on organizing your body. Pearl is in heat right now. She is the first dog that I've never got spayed, the first female dog that I never got spayed, because I just can't stomach the thought of taking her to the vet to get surgery. Look at that little tail go. She's a doll. But again, my dogs are in good shape because I'm in good shape. I won't let them get overweight. That's how I feel like life works. I believe, like for me, I need a clean environment to start. I can be dirty. Like if I might need a shower, but if my room's clean first, then I'll get a shower because I'm going to get sweaty if I'm cleaning, you know. So clean my house, clean myself, you know, clear up my work. Everything is organized. That I think is the key. Being organized is a massive key to success. I think she finally found her comfortable spot. Anyway, well, I hope you liked seeing the Hoarder house. I do. As soon as I get this project done, it will probably be about another month, my guess, before this entire project is done. Primarily because I had to order windows, and the windows, they told me it takes between 8 to 10 weeks for those. They were custom sizes, so they had to be built. So those are being built now. I ordered them September 10th, so it should be like November 10th or so. So that's not quite a month away, but by then the election will be over, so that's good. That will be behind us, at least for us in America. We'll have that over with, thank God. So, just giving you a little sneak peek of some of the things to come. But thank you for tuning in tonight. I appreciate you so much. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, if you have subscribed, please give me a like. I appreciate you so much.